money.
What's up, guys? I'm doing a video of Call of the Dead again. Yes, I know. But this is my review slash tell everything about it video. So I'm going to tell you what I think about it. And George, starting off, I want to talk about George. He is absolutely fine. He's easy. You can get rid of him in many ways, which I'll talk about later. But the thing about it is, if you have noobs or people that are just trolls, they're going to shoot him and try to fuck you up. That's a bad thing. I don't really enjoy the idea of trolls always just shooting him and you tell them not to, but they continue to shoot him, and it really sucks. That's the only downside of George. Besides that, he's simple. Don't mess with him. Keep him around the water. You know, each round, change him. And that's pretty much it. So you get George out the way around round 3 or 4. You want to open this door and get a gun. If the box is by the lighthouse, you can go over there and get that too. But I recommend you just getting that gun and coming up here, because you're going to want to work toward getting Jug. And if you come up here, you could pretty much camp here with the whole group, which my guys didn't do. They ran toward the box. So I decided to camp here alone, get points, save up for Jug, and not worry about the box. So come up here, try to get your group together, and pretty much just camp here. You can hold it off. If it gets rough, go down the zip line, start all over again. And it's a pretty simple strategy, so I'm pretty much just doing work here. And I want to give a little bit of strategy through this review. You know, I can't really just give a review without really telling you how it works. So you have to pretty much, you know, stay away from these zombies and build up points. Jug costs a lot of money. Jug costs around, I think it is 75 grand to actually unlock anything, counting guns and Jug itself, before you can even get Jug. And that'll be around 6 or 7, and that's if you rush to it. And that's, you can get it around 6 if your teammates help, but mine didn't at all. They just went and got the box, and I had to unlock Jug all by myself. Which is something you have to get used to in your solo round. It's definitely a strategy you have to get used to, and definitely one I don't enjoy. So I go here, I hit the box, because it respawned by me after they nuked it, so it kind of worked to my advantage coming here. Like I said, don't be a box whore. Go out here and camp and save for Jug, because you gotta think ahead. You know what I mean? You can't be thinking like, oh, I just want to get a weapon. You gotta think about those higher levels. So yeah, we get an insta-kill. They finally decide to show up, and guess what I get? A snipe. I'm not gonna trade this gun in. I have plans for it. I'll show you later. So I run up here and I protect myself. Do not be greedy. Don't let it cost you. These guys freak me out. They're using the new weapon to shoot the guy. He must have got the new weapon. They freak me out. I see him pass by. I'm like, oh my god, a zombie. I want to shoot him. Anyway, I finally get the Jug. Finally, after unlocking it all myself. You see the yellow guy go up the stairs. Didn't help whatsoever. But whatever. Like I said, you have to expect this. You have to be anticipating it. So I go up there. I get Jug. It's cold down here. But like I said, it cost a lot of money to finally get to Jug. As you see, I'm around 7. It took me a while to buy it all myself, which I did. Make sure no one's coming. And then go get Jug. After you get Jug, then you start taking hits and actually start running around the map. By this time, everyone else is running their heads off, getting hurt. But now you can actually go start getting guns yourself. So you go hit the box. I use this trampoline. It bounces them off in a way, which is great. I love that. I use it very often. It is a great new add-in on the game. But see that shake? You see how George shook the screen and I had to switch my guns really fast, almost got killed? When you shoot George and he shakes like that, it screws up every player, and that's just really bad. I also hit it one more time, and I get the moneymaker. And the moneymaker is the key. It is a very great gun. You're going to want this gun over probably any other gun. Like, even, like, ray gun. Ray gun's good, but if you have ray gun and you don't have flopper, it's gonna end up killing you. But let's talk about the perks a little bit before I get into anything else. Perks, right off the top of my head. You got Juggernaut, you know, gives you life. You got flopper, which you do a dolphin dive off something, explode. Plus, also, you get no fire damage. Stamina up, quick revive, speed cola. We got double tap. We have this new one called Deadshot Daiquiri. Deadshot Daiquiri, I guess it pretty much makes your side shooting turn into quick scoping. I'm not sure how it works, but I heard it just helps you get headshots better. It's weird. But the perks are great. You want to start building up your perks after this, and with this round, this gun, you can just build up your ammo to well around 15 and 20 and be perfectly fine. Just, you know, use the whole map. My guys that got up here are team working together. It's going great. I want to talk about the new weapons while we're here. There are three new weapons. Two of them I want to talk about. There's a new sniper, and there's this new weird gun that looks like a portal gun that turns zombies into humans, but then they run away and end up killing themselves. But one's really good and one's really bad. The sniper's really good and the other one's kind of crap, but you need both of them to do this Easter egg right here. You will need, by the end of this Easter egg, you will need to shoot a zombie and turn him into a human, and then also shoot him with a sniper and blow him up to get the last bit of this particular Easter egg. But also, these guns are good for getting rid of the boss. If you shoot the boss with a human gun that upgrade, you have to upgrade them both first to do this, he will go underneath the water for a set amount of time. And if you shoot him with a sniper about 20 or 30 times, which is ridiculous, but it works, he will actually go away and die for a few rounds, and you get a free perk. Do this 3 times, and you can get up to 7 perks on this round. That's crazy. But if you do this mission and complete it and have all the new guns, you will end up unlocking a very special gun. And it is the Wunderwaffe. I've actually never used this gun, but it's amazing. You pretty much shoot, and it makes this lightning bolt, and all the zombies get shocked. It's an amazing gun. I've seen it in use, and it's awesome. The secrets in this game are insane. There is so many Easter eggs, it's not even funny. To the weird ship ports that make sounds, to that Easter egg I just showed you, it gets crazy. But for high level strategies, here's my strategy. This bridge right here, set up claymores to the end to make sure they don't come up, and just keep watching it. So this is like level 25, we got pretty high up there, it's one of my highest levels. But there you go, someone did get hit by it. You have to kind of watch out for people coming behind you and people coming up, but this is a really good straight shot, and that's what I really like about it. So it's really good for strategies. Also, I don't have sound on here, my bad, I'll put a little music in the background while I'm talking. But this puts in for really good strategies for level 25. Here's me blasting him, but damn, George started hauling ass, so I had to do the circle. But he pretty much just circled back. It's not too big of a deal, and cool George off. Gotta watch out for him those high levels, he can mess you up. But I had the ray gun, and I had the double pistols with the rocket launchers. If you save your pistol and upgrade it, which is what I was doing in the earlier part of this video, it can end up helping you out a lot. You just simply run around with like an AK, build up points that way, and if you get swarmed, you pull them out really quick, or you should have them out and just blast them on the ground. It kills everything around you with the rockets. They're really convenient, and you know, it's my strategy personally. And the nuke saved our day. We actually made it, and that was pretty epic save. But yeah, you guys, you're gonna want to work on your own strategy. Do what's best for you. Teamwork helps at first to get jugged, but as you see, I can do it without it. You can too. You just really, this map, it's really good. I like it a lot. My review for it is a 9 out of 10. It would get the 10 out of 10, but I don't think anything's perfect. And plus, this map is really hard. It takes you all day to get to Jug, and it's very difficult, but it has tons of secrets. It's huge. It is very fun. I honestly can't stop playing it. I do like Extension better, but they're both two different maps. This map is not one to circle on. You know, you have George, you can not camp that much. You really just have to learn how to run routes and take care of yourself. It's a fantastic map. I recommend you buy it just for this, not alone the other maps that come with it. But yeah, that's my review. Hope you guys enjoyed it. Rate, let me know, comment, help us out. That's DuckFins, and we are out.